environment, targeting the virus outside. We are using what? Sanitizers or disinfectants. Spray and make sure the virus is dead on surfaces. Door handles, work, you know. If you come to my home now, there's a hand wash outside. But anyway, we are not allowing in people. But like me who goes out, I don't greet anybody. I don't talk to anybody until I have gone and removed my clothing and sanitized myself. The kids who are coming to hug me at the car, we don't hug, we don't shake hands, even in the family. Because we still had some students who are going out. My mother, who is the most vulnerable individual, you sit there, I don't allow anybody to approach her closely. She was like, take me to the village, and no way, you are here. Until this is over, I'm going to protect you from them. So then the other thing is we are targeting change in behavior. And mostly this is, we are targeting hand washing, hand wash. Africans, there is a way we have looked at washing hands. Initially, it was just before you eat, after you eat, especially after you eat. Especially, we wash hands after you eat. At least wash before you eat, then you can deal with it after you eat. We've never seen hand washing. By the way, hand washing is the most powerful public health tool that we have. It can prevent up to 70-80% of the diseases that you suffer from. Washing hands. Although you are sneezing, the virus is here, but the way to stop it from reaching you, the power lies in your hands. So hand washing, wash your hands. By the way, if you can't get the sanitizer, hand washing is effective. Get soap, get running water, and wash your hands. And we will demonstrate to you the best way to wash hands here. If we can get a bowl and maybe a piece of soap from the hotel, so that we do some practicing of how to wash your hands. Sometimes we wash our hands, but we leave them dirty. We leave them still able to infect us. So the WHO Director General has, there's a video which has been circulating with him demonstrating how we should wash our hands, especially for this purpose. So hand washing, the other change in behavior is hand management. Hand management, hand washing is just washing your hands, but hand management, how do you manage your hands? Now this is so important because you can't wash your hands all the time. Now you can have the virus on your hands. I could have the virus on my hands, but it doesn't affect me until I wash, if I can manage my hands properly. Remember I told you the deadly holes. Where are they?
Yes.
On the face. So the simple message is keep your hands off your face. Keep your hands off your face. It's possible for me to pick the virus from this cloth, and I have it for 5 hours, and maybe it has already died. So sometimes the virus does not stay for long, but the way we manage our hands is the hand which moves. You know that all the other parts of the body don't touch each other. Some people have never realized. I can walk, step in, poop somewhere, but my feet will not put that poop in my mouth until I touch the feet and then touch my mouth. And then I will get cholera. You know cholera is eating feces. When you eat, when you enjoy eating and drinking feces, you get cholera. Even to be no mesomesem in church. Teach your people. It's unchristian to eat feces. Let me not go there. So, manage your hands.
Until this pandemic, mm-hmm. we never came to really take some of these issues. And we spend a lot of money on medical.
Uh-huh, no more fundraising. You fundraise in church, you go and visit your faithful in hospital and pray for them, and yet you could have stopped by telling them. And if you tell them, you know that you command them to do so many things they do. If you command them not to drink feces, not to eat feces, they will not. But if you are talking, please, if you can first get the thing yourself. Now let me give you some tips. Because sometimes we touch our face without thinking, because something has happened. Because the only thing that any sensation that we feel needs intervention on our face, we touch. For example, if something falls in your eye, you touch. Mm-hmm. If you feel your nose needs to blow, you blow. If you want to sneeze, but this is the very harmful. Then kataburuganda. And then over here, donating, lovingly donating virus to you. Corona. I am giving you some corona, eh? The love portion you are giving. Monsonyuri, forgive me for that. Aboruganda, then Janguan, come and help me preach. Katono Uruganda, no. You are touching them. You are donating corona out of love. So I want us to be conscious of our hands, and I want to show you a few things that you can do to reduce. One, make a covenant, like Job made one with his eyes. Yeah? Job, in the Bible, made a covenant. What was the covenant with his eyes?
His eyes will never look at a woman.
They will not look at a woman twice. No, twice. He knew the first one may be involuntary. But the second one, he has to make a decision not to do it. So I want you to make a covenant with your hands. I'm talking. Uh-huh. I want you to take your hand from where it is now. Yes. I will make a covenant with my hands not to touch my face. Make a covenant. The hands will not touch my face. Except when you are washing what? Your face. Yeah, because you first wash your hands. But any other time, just don't touch your face. There should be no excuse. What if it is itching? This is, for me, this is what I do. I pick my clothes, whichever I'm wearing, and for us women, you have variety. You men, you are okay. You have the same. So what I teach you, so, unyambe kubuliomu akwate kubuliomu. Don't put your finger this way. Just get this near the, because this one doesn't get a lot of, put a little bit. You are not holding like me. Like, you see, I've picked from outside. Like this. And I'm going to get a piece. Because I'm going to use my thumb to push a piece from inside. And I'm going to clean my now for you, you are touching inside. You see, my fingers are not anywhere inside. They don't touch the inner part. I'm demanding this, I'm the teacher. So everybody do it. Everybody do it. You pick. Pick from clothes. You see? This. Then I'll turn and my thumb will push through a piece which is clean. And this can do this. It can clean my, and if I can scratch, but without my hands touching my face. Now I want to see. Can somebody come and help me demonstrate? Teach Jamu Nyambe to solve this issue. But again, graduate is a good one. there was no hand.
Teach. Yeah. I was wearing this one.
Yeah.
I have a problem.
Itching in your nose.
So I want to get myself.
Speak a bit close.
Closer to the neck. Closer.
Then you use your thumb.
Use your thumb.
So if suddenly you don't have tissue, you don't have what? People are saying handkerchiefs. I have a lot of reservations about handkerchiefs. I don't encourage people to use handkerchiefs.
Unless if you're changing them.
How many times do you change handkerchiefs?
You see, the handkerchief becomes a deposit of waste, human waste, which you are storing. Maybe the people don't understand. I don't know how to say it. I can't make it sound better in Luganda. Can you help me? You see, what you put in the hanky is waste. It is human waste. It needs something which is no longer useful in the body, and the body has wanted to get rid of it. So the waste we have are mucus, urine, and feces. So it's putting something in your hanky and then keep it in the pocket is equivalent to going to a toilet. Put it in a cavern. So anyway, but the president was saying you can wash it and iron, because for him he was thinking more practical. If you can, if you don't have access to tissue, but if you have even access to the cheapest disposable tissue, you fold it, so when you remove it out, the part you're touching is not outside. You sneeze and throw away. Don't keep for later use. Throw in a dustbin. Don't throw there where other people get the infection. In a place where you can. But as much as possible. If you must use a hanky, wash it. If you can't iron it, because you are going to have people who don't have irons, if you cannot, but they wash it in water with salt. Salt dissolves mucus. So when you put salt in the water, then soak the hanky. All the mucus break, and all the germs there, salt also kills some of the germs. Then if you don't have a flat iron, spread it in sunshine. Sunshine kills the viruses. Spread it in bright sunshine. If you can't iron, then you need to have more than one. But if you can, please use tissue. Use tissue. Okay, now who can show us how to clean your face if suddenly something is itching? Or because these things happen to me when I'm driving, when I'm working. I just read. Now I've practiced it for many years that it just comes automatically. I never pick my eye. Uh-huh. Yes, use the thumb to push so that the rest of your hand does not get close to the face. Because the parts of the hand we use to touch ourselves are usually the same ones that we use to touch surfaces, and we get contaminated. Now, the second thing we are going to learn is, how do you cough and sneeze in public? Yes?
Yes, I can use my thumb. Mm-hmm.
Suppose I am in the garden.
Are you naked?
I am in the garden, I am digging. And I am sweating. How may I help myself?
She's asking, are you naked?
No. Are you in the garden digging?
You still have a shirt. Whatever you're wearing, you want poisonous. What do you do? You're a lady.
The shirt is dirty.
You are driving and your eyes itchy. I'm telling you that shirt is dirty but cleaner than your hands.
You're dirty shirt.
Okay.
The shirt is dirty, and cleaner than your hands. Yeah. Okay, so, and for us ladies, we put on all sorts of things, and I usually assess, will this allow me to clean my face in case of an emergency, what I'm wearing. So if I don't have, then I'll carry a scarf. A scarf, not a hand. These scarves we carry, so I'll pick, I usually either have it close to where I'm driving. For me, even this tissue is better than for you touching your face without something in your hands. Now, the next thing is coughing. Coughing. We know that we have been picking up if you have the hanky. If not, you just stand away or you cough in your hands, so you turn, you know. Now, the safest way, cough your corona, is cough in your elbow. And if you have a long sleeve, the clothes, the better. Because the virus doesn't survive very long on fabric.
Fabric?
Yeah. And if you deposit it here, it's unlikely that it will touch anywhere. Another person will do what? Will pick it. So, yeah. You know, the purpose is not to allow the droplets to spread. Okay? For me, it is now a habit. It helps me, I feel I'm protecting the people around me. Now, WHO, can you come and help me? We demonstrate hand washing.
I'll find it slide.
No, we want to demonstrate it live. When people follow slides, whatever.
No, I'll find a picture.
Oh. Can somebody come and help me? Let me demonstrate. This is a very, very powerful thing. The cheapest soap. It doesn't have to be medicated, doesn't have to smell. Just this can prevent you, can protect you and your family from corona. So long as you use it. It's not a magic thing. So first, of course, you need to wet the soap and wet the hands a bit. Put enough soap. Some people fear that this soap will contaminate them, not really, it will not. Because it kills, it partially kills the viruses, not completely, it's not effective as the others, but also whatever gets on it gets off very fast. So your hands have parts. You have to make sure that all parts are washed. So I've put soap in my hands. And my first responsibility is to wash. You know you have grooves in your hands, and mucus can stay there. So the first is, it's not this just rubbing hands. This hand is washing this what? Hand. And this hand is washing this hand. So be deliberate. I am washing this hand, you know. So wash. Now we are cleaning the palms. Okay. We are cleaning the palms. But then there are these parts here, which we have to make sure that they are clean. You clean in here, and you clean in here. Who, have you followed me?
Yes.
It usually takes a very short time. Huh? So pour some little water for me. again. Now, if you still have the soap, you just need to turn and wash the back of your hand. It's not a matter, you wash the back and you wash in between. If you have a ring, wash with your ring on. Don't remove it first because then the ring is going to retain that. So you are cleaning in here and then you clean here because this part is the one which handles most things. So make effort to make sure you are cleaning there. I'm also going to go to this one. I'm going to wash it because sometimes you rub your face with the back. Okay. So I'm going to wash, I'm washing it, not just rubbing hands together. And I'm washing again in between, you know, my, and then the last part to wash are the fingertips. You are washing the fingertips, not wetting them. You know, things can hide in here. So when you wash, it is not a matter of I saw people just rubbing here. No, you are trying to get that place between the ball of the finger and the nail clean. So you are going to use this hand to wash all of them. You are moving each of them on the palm and getting the detergent getting there. And you are going to do the same for this one. Not just rubbing there. When you see the doctors doing it for you, you think they just rub there. No, they are washing from one to the other, getting the things getting there. Now I'm ready to rinse. Okay. I'm ready to rinse everywhere. I'm ready to rinse. Okay. Now I need a volunteer. If to see whether I'm a good teacher or not.
I will talk for you. Mm.
And when we are washing, we don't wash like this. We wash the hands. No hands on the faces. We are making covenants with our hands never to touch our faces.
It's not a joke.
I was very far, but I was watching.
You follow the steps.
There is no follow the steps provided. I don't have a ring, by the way. What
happened? Let us evaluate him and guide him. It's, by the way, if you master the steps, it takes less than 20 seconds to wash your hands.
Less than 20 seconds?
Yeah.
Okay.
So long as you know what to do. Now it looks long and complicated.
So we give marks?
No.
Mm-hmm. Before you give me marks, come and wash.
Okay.
Yeah.
Follow the steps there. Very detailed ones.
Mm-hmm. There, you see a 20 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
You apply there. That is the.
That's where the soap is.
The first one.
1A and 1B is just to ensure that you have soap.
Soap, right?
Yeah.
And then
you have to move around. Mm-hmm. You count five.
Five, right?
At least five. You just see. And moreover, like this. Like this, you are not washing. You imagine this hand is washing the other. Not that you are rubbing your hands together. No, this hand is washing the other hand. And then this hand is washing the other hand.
Then you're going to the.
Then?
This is the back.
Yes. You are washing the
back.
Both backs. This back and then this back.
That one is in between the fingers.
This one?
Number four.
So there. You are washing.
In between the fingers.
In between the fingers.
In between.
Yeah. Okay.
And then the tips of the fingers.
These are the tips of the fingers.
Yeah.
And then this is the
thumb.
The thumb. Yeah. And then again.
Now here you are washing this.
This
last one. No, you are washing your. There is this. There is washing this. Because you see, you have space here. And many times, even people get a significant layer of that just there. So this cleans these fingertips. Now this one, this one is to wash this part. You see this part?
Can we put this one? Where? Yeah? The nails.
On the knuckles.
Hey, the knuckles, that's right. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Here, there is that it goes into there. And then there is here. That's the knuckle, and then the
Then you have the water. Then you can dry your hands. Please don't use towels now. Dry those towels, they hang on things. No.
Because somebody has already.
Just leave your hands like in outer, like this in the public hotel, they will put there a towel. Your hands can easily dry without being dry. If you have tissue, you can use that to dry your hands or you substitute the places where they have hand blowing. But if you don't have, just leave your hands, they will dry very quickly. Mine are already dry.
How about the hand dryer and the washer?
They have. You can use them.
Some people, we are recommending people to use heat, like in water.
That is for sanitizer.
Is it okay?
Yeah. It adds disinfectant to the water.
But whatever it is,
we need one more person. We need
whether you use jik in the pre-mixed water or you use soap,
this time
go through the same steps.
Yes. Me? Oh.
Yes.
Okay.
Come and follow the steps. And you score him.
You stand.
I stand this way.
So that because you are going to teach other people.
Yeah.
You are going to teach your pastors. You are going to teach other people.
Follow the order, so that you can remember.
Yeah. Supposing I don't have the chat.
You are recording, you so must
you
do the right
thing. You need to become and once it is yours,
you are recording, you do the right thing.
Please, go ahead.
It is very safe for that for me.
Okay, you wash.
Go ahead. Let me.
But
we have told us this hand must be washing the other.
You rub at least 5 times.
5 times. Well, I think those are more.
The other one. Then?
This is 5 times.
The back. Wash the back also.
Five.
And then push.
Don't raise hands.
Don't do this and don't put the hands above the other.
I'm trying to save this ring from falling. Let me use one.
It is a saucepan. It will not flush.
Sure. I don't want it to go there.
Who is the sick?
The antivirus might be that in the ring.
No. Uh-huh. And in between the fingers. And you need to move. You see, you don't just do this. You do
All the way.
Don't just, because if you just do this, that means the other parts.
There's
so you wash here first and then move. Make sure you wash it on the sides. Uh-huh.
Yes. Then this one. Uh-huh. I have to.
2, 3, 4, 5. Each. Let's standardize. Each.
Five.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Then.
The other side.
This one, look at this.
I finished this side.
It washes the neck of the where we have the nails.
I have finished this side. So I was on this side.
Yes.
Now I'm going on the nails.
Uh-huh. No, this. You see that?
Yeah.
Cleaning. See that step 5?
Cleaning this other side.
Those are knuckles. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then?
There is this, this one here.
You are going to clean the energy. Open your palm. Open your hand. You see it there? You are doing this. You are actually washing in between. It's not a matter of you putting them like this. You are opening the space between.
People with long nails.
You are squeezing your throat. We'll be religious about it for now until you master it.
4, 5.
Okay. Never lift your hands above your elbows when you're washing.
Hey.
Because so, now everywhere, no? You are pushing them this way.
So my nails.
So the hands should always be
there.
The hands should always
so,
be
there.
Then the nails.
No.
I'm finished. This is enough.
Yeah, we medically we don't encourage anybody to pick nails. Just chop them off. They are very tissue.
Okay.
I know it's supposed to be a That's why I'm speaking personally. Otherwise, you'll have to spray what is there.
We have to learn to wash them.
But so as over no Marango Savirava, you will be praying for the kingdom of God to come.
So it means we don't need to encourage anyone to wash hands without soap.
It's really a futile exercise. Soap and water. And the water should not be poured in the dish the way they drink.
Everyone. Discovered last night. We should leave that.
At least the one, especially the ugali, may be okay because everybody is.
But the sauce.
But the sauce everybody must use. I'm not saying must use their own things. Because you are bringing saliva from the hand, you know how we do. Then even to remove the sauce which has gone on the side, you lick the fingers.
Right, that one you need to repeat the lesson for every single day. Yeah?
Everybody should have their own sauce.
You need to repeat it.
You say it yourself.
Everybody look at it. Yeah, the look at
it. Should we postpone kissing?
Kissing, we are not touching anybody. We are staying a meter away. 2 meters.
Which kissing you talk about? Your wife, you talk about your wife.
Exchanging saliva with
you. You know, somebody was asking me, I had a TV program in the night. And somebody was asking, now, what about us if we are already married? For you, you are already exchanging the virus by being close. So anything else you do is not going to be protected.
You have already signed.
Yeah, you're already there. But if somebody, if I realize I might be exposed and say peace,
oh, that's
stay away.
Yeah, but.
And we have one side so that you be at the back. Mukuru Kadu. Mm-hmm. Can we have one? So
I know the temptation is that we will only use those steps when we are washing hands. Mm. But also when you are using the alcohol and wrap.
Uh-huh. Do we have any for the here? Because people just put here and do this. Yeah. And they even sometimes they just put some little here for ceremonial purposes. Yeah. They, in fact, I watch people, they just put and they go. That is useless. You are supposed to go, you put the alcohol, you rub it in here, you rub it in your hand, you rub it on the outer hands, you rub it in here, you rub it in your to make sure every part is sanitized.
So this sanitizer has to go through the same process.
Yes.
So that means we need enough of it.
Yes.
Doctor, as we are going to teach the community, but there is another faith, Islamic faith, those who wash the dead body. What advice do you give us?
We are under a religious council. We are working with all these different faiths.
Okay.
So each is going to have a theme of training. We might have to invite this because I don't think that a group of sheikhs and imams will listen to and at this point, our aim is not...
But coronavirus is reshaping the whole thing.
I know.
They will have
so they
have no choice.
It's not...
The concentration is too low.
It is not what? It is not level. So it's what time.
Now, when we have epidemics like this, a lot of fake things come on the market. Don't just look and buy because they have labeled it sanitizer and gel. You know? Like this one, we don't know what sanitizer is there. It's in a language I can't see. And I don't know what active ingredient is there. It's difficult for me to know whether this thing kills the virus. So in fact, for me, I was recommending that Saraya thing. It's just alcohol. It's not a gel. You just take. So many of you are going to the supermarket or pharmacy and pick it.
Yes,
now this one will even be harmful because you will think, oh, I sanitized my hands, so. And then you touch your face.
This one is 67. It has to be 75.
That is 67.
We actually use 65 plus.
Is it 75?
75.
Yeah, there's another, but before you answer.
It's okay, it's written on it. It's written on it.
That is a sanitizer should be 75.
Yes, at least.
Should I touch it?
So that one is 67.
Active ingredient, this is 75. But now you also need to know that alcohol, which is the one in here which kills the germs, it escapes. It evaporates. So if you've been keeping that thing, first of all, you should always keep the bottle closed to keep it in there. But also if you have opened it several times, most likely the alcohol content has dropped. And so you have a gel, but it does not kill the germs. If you leave, always leaving the bottle open and open it for long, it will. You will just be having a gel and the alcohol has gone. So use this is just a first aid when you're moving, but even if you have just applied this and you find somewhere with water, wash your hands. Wash your hands, water, and soap. I don't care which type of soap, so long as it's soap. Wash your hands with soap and water. Even if when you go out there, people cannot afford these sanitizers. And sometimes if you give them, if they look like a medicine, people will drink. So the message you should take is wash your hands with soap and running water. Yeah, they don't even have the capacity to know which one works.
And what if the water is
It is better to wash your hands with that water than not wash your hands.
So for the day, when is it being used?
When you are in places where you cannot wash your hands and you're not sure. For example, I've been in a taxi. And I know many people have touched there. And I'm going to touch my phone, I'm going to pick things in my bag. So there, yes, the door, you hold on to those things. And many people have been holding on to them. Many people have been. So you've been in a place where you have touched places, but you can't wash your hands. In the toilet, you should wash your hands before you get out. If it is the bitter thing, tell the people to have water there. So, at least let them have water. So, at least we can all afford water and a piece of soap. One of the things we used in Sierra Leone to fight Ebola was to make sure people have water and soap. The government went as far as distributing a soap tablet to our family to show you how important it was. So I hope, let me just recap. We are beating the virus by reducing crowds, because when people are crowded and they are close together, the virus can move directly from saliva of a person to the nose, to the eyes, to the mouth of the next person. And it can drop on surfaces where other people are touching and they can pick it. So that's the reason. We call it social distancing, that's the technical word. So when you hear everybody talking about social distancing, that's what the environment we are trying to create. We're trying to make sure we don't have big groups of people to infect many big people, but also stay away from within the reach of saliva or cough or sputum of another person. Okay? Try to stay. And when you have big groups, it's difficult to ensure that. Secondly, we want to make sure the virus does not get to into our bodies by washing our hands and making sure they are clean. As long as you are outside your home, even if you have washed, assume your hands are not clean. Don't touch your face. Make a covenant with your hands never to touch your face. Let's live consciously with this for a while. I always ask people, how many of you this morning came here without washing your face? You didn't wash your face?
We washed.
Why? Or at home, even if Musumba, they come and knock and say, somebody's outside wants to see you. You say, let me first wash my face. Why do you wash your face?
There is the ejection of gases and what from within the body.
Mm-hmm.
So you are conscious there is even a smell, a stench that is in your mouth.
You don't want the other person to think that you smell badly. Do you know why we wash our faces? It was introduced as a public health measure to control trachoma.
Trachoma, the eyes.
Yes. Africa had a lot of trachoma. And when you wake up, you have a lot of bunini.
Yeah.
We never used to wash our faces. Our great grandparents never used to wash their faces. But when they came and saw, and then so people would wake up, try to clean their eyes, then greet their friends. The face washing controlled trachoma to a level that you don't see it. Of course, they came in with other things, but the public health measure, very efficient, nobody knows. So we want to make hand washing so fashionable, so trendy, so culturally. You know, if I see you and you have not washed, how can you move without washing your hands? We want it not to be about corona, but let it be. It should even be part of your doctrine. that you wash your hands. Okay, no, I'm joking. You don't include it in the Bible. It's not, but in the, that was the intention when God introduced it as a ritual. It does not itself make you clean, but it prevents a lot of diseases. Then we want to reduce physical contact between the human being parts. So don't shake hands. Please don't shake hands. Because you are passing on the virus. Keep away from crowds. Wash your hands. Don't shake hands. Don't touch other people. Always wash your hands. So that's the summary of the message. When you are sick, stay at home. That's something I'd forgotten. Wearing surgical gloves when you are walking around is not going to protect you. No? It does nothing. Unless you are working in an environment where you are cleaning things. But walking around, I see people walking around with these surgical gloves. Then after, when their faces, because now that has become the outer part of your hand. So they will, because they have gloves, they will touch everywhere, then they will rub their faces, then they will. So you don't need gloves except people who work in cleaning. Who are cleaning. They need a gloves, one, protect themselves from any germs which may be there, and two, they don't want to also spread. So they can use gloves, they don't want the chemicals to harm them. Yeah. So they don't want the chemicals.